At the end of this module, you should be able to perform element-by-element operations and identify when and explain why an intended element-by-element operation will not execute properly. Let's look at a problem that will better help us understand these learning objectives. An engineer is working on the design of a treadmill and needs to better understand how users perform at the start of their workout. Distance and time data have been provided for a user using a treadmill at resistance level 7 and are shown in this table. The engineer wishes to compute average velocity and average acceleration at each of the distance values. However, after entering the data into MATLAB, errors in the data were identified. These errors were due to mistakes in calibration. The total time values are 1 second behind. Therefore, we need to add 1 second to each of these values, and the distance values in the table are double what they should be. The data shown here are representative of a larger data set. We are using a few values here to demonstrate how to perform these operations in MATLAB. Let's first make sure we are performing our calculations correctly by checking them in Excel. In the corrected distance column, I will need to divide each value by 2. I can use cell referencing to make life easier. In the corrected total time column, I will need to add 1 to each value. Now I can also drag that down. The rest of the problem requires that we calculate the average velocity, which is distance divided by time, for each data point. And finally, I will calculate the average acceleration, which is distance divided by time squared, and drag that down for each data point. Now let's look at how we can do this in MATLAB. I have already created the original distance and time variables I need to compute the calculations in the MATLAB workspace, as you can see here. Let's make the corrections next. I need to add 1 to all of the total time values. I can do this in one step by adding the scalar value 1 to the total time vector. Similarly, I can divide all of the distance values by 2. Notice that the names of the corrected variables containing the distance and time values are appended with an underscore followed by cor to represent corrected distance and corrected total time. Now I want to use the corrected values to compute the average speed at each distance value. Let's apply the formula. We will say user average speed is equal to the corrected distance divided by the corrected total time. The purpose is to divide each distance value by the corresponding time value. We therefore expect a vector with 5 elements. This only gives me 1 value rather than 5 values, and the value doesn't match anything I was expecting. Let's try and figure out why. This is actually happening because MATLAB, by default, wants to do matrix mathematics rather than element by element mathematics. But what does that mean? Let's look at a generic example, and let's look at multiplication rather than division. In element-by-element multiplication, each element of the first vector is multiplied by the element in the same position in the second vector. Here, I have created 2 vectors, A and B. When I multiply using a dot followed by a multiplication sign, I am essentially telling MATLAB to take each element in A and multiply it by the element in B that holds the same position. Notice that I can do this for both division and raising to the power. One important thing to note is that since MATLAB uses elements that are located in the same position to perform element-by-element operations for the 2 vectors, the array dimensions must match or you will get an error. Here, D is a 6-element vector, and A is a 5-element vector. When we try to perform element-by-element multiplication between A and D in MATLAB, we get an error telling us that the matrix dimensions must agree, just as we expected. As we've noted, MATLAB defaults to matrix multiplication, but the vectors must be dimensioned appropriately to do this or an error will result. In my MATLAB example, I have 2 row vectors A and B, so when I try to multiply them, I get the error that the inner matrix dimensions must agree. For vectors, this means that they must be of the same length. In this example, the first vector is a row vector, the second is a column vector. Each element of the row is multiplied by each element of the column, and a sum is taken. Thus, a single scalar value results. In my MATLAB example, I had to transpose B to a column vector to get the computation to execute. Matrix mathematics is beyond the scope of this course. You will not be held responsible for the understanding of how it works. But you do need to understand why you might not be getting the results you are expecting when you perform certain calculations in MATLAB. Always take note of the dimensions of your arrays and predict the dimensions of the results. Also, predict some output values in order to verify your results. So let's return to our problem. If I want to compute the average velocity for each distance value, I need to force element by element division with a period character, as we saw in our multiplication example earlier. Let's try this new calculation and see if we get the correct values for velocity. It looks like this time we get the velocity values we expect. From our problem, our final calculation is the average acceleration. Here I have to square the total time values. If I do not use the period character, I get an error. You have to be somewhat careful with scalars. They cannot always be used without the period character. The exponent character always requires a period when working with arrays bigger than 1 by 1. So when I fix the problem by adding a period sign, we see that we are getting the correct values, similar to our Excel calculations. Let's also see what happens if I multiply the distance by the reciprocal of total time to get average velocity. If I do not use a period character in the 1 over the total time, I get a matrix dimension error. So dividing a scalar by an array will also result in an error. We can fix this by adding a dot before the division symbol. With a slight modification to our original problem, we can have 2 users' worth of data as I show here. I put the 2 users' distance values in 1 array, 1 column per user. Similarly, I put both users' total time values in a 2nd array in the same order that I created the distance array, with the 1st user taking up column 1 and the 2nd user taking up column 2. So once again, I can use element by element division on the arrays to compute user 1 and user 2's average velocity and assign the values to a single array. Let's summarize what we have learned in this module. We learned that element by element operations require the dimensions of the arrays to match, and the result is an array of the same dimensions. We know that element by element computations may need to be managed with a period character. The following never require a period character: addition and subtraction, multiplication of a scalar and an array, and division of an array by a scalar. And finally, these element by element operations require a period character: multiplication, division, and exponentiation of arrays, division of a scalar by an array, and exponentiation involving a scalar.